in the modeling industry for years, everybody knew about Brunel, you know, that he was a predator. Nobody cared, you know, because people were there to make money, and it was a kind of culture to look the other way. Every single day, he was like harassing me with remarks like, you and me, we're gonna have sex one of these days. It made me feel really uncomfortable, but I wanted to handle it, you know. So I remember that I kind of tried to make jokes about it, telling him that he was too small for me or that he was too old for me. But then one night we went out and we came back in his place, and I wanted to go to sleep, and then Jean-Luc, he was like saying, no, you know, we should celebrate some more. And he gave me a drink, and he said, I made it for you, especially because you like, I don't like wine, beer. And we were sitting in the living room, and I remember that like maybe 20 minutes after that, I felt, you know, like really dizzy and with a kind of blurred vision, and also the sounds were strange. And I had the feeling that I had to throw up. So I remember that Jean-Luc, he said to me like, okay, I'm gonna take care of you. You have to lie down. And he took me to his bedroom. And I remember, because from that moment on, I remember parts what happened, but there are also some strange black holes. I remember that I thought, okay, I don't want this. But I didn't have the kind of power to say no or something. I remember that I also said, like, you know, I'm not gonna stay here in your bed. But he pushed me on the bed and he said, no, you have to stay here. And I remember that I felt really strange, and I remember that he was on top of me, that he tried to kiss me, and that I tried to fight him, but I remember that he was kind of enjoying. He ripped my shirt, and he tried to get under it, and then he ripped it. He was on top of me, and that I had the feeling that I couldn't breathe, that it was really, you know, heavy, and that he was like penetrating me. And from that moment, I don't remember what really happened. I woke up the next morning. Then, you know, it started to come back to me that I was in Brunel's bed. He was not there. And I had the feeling that I couldn't really move my limbs, you know, that it felt like I was really tired. And and then I started to get my, you know, parts of my memory back of what happened that night. And I felt really sick, you know, to my stomach. And the first thing I wanted to do was to leave, you know, I wanted to leave right away. The strange thing is that I knew that I was raped, but for me, the word rape was something that I didn't want to think of, you know, because I felt really ashamed, and I also felt guilty because I let myself into that situation. And I for years, you know, I told myself, you know, it's your own fault because you didn't say no or enough. I read a blog from another victim of Brunel, Zoe Brock, and yeah, it was so. It was like, on one hand, it felt like okay, you are not the only one. So it was a kind of reassurance, like, I'm not crazy. That it's not my fault, you know. But on the other hand, it felt, when I read everything that what he did with Epstein, it was like, you know, it made me like, so it made me sick, you know. There was also a thought that, like, okay, because you didn't speak up, you know, because you didn't go to the police, nothing happened to this guy, you know, and he could go on and on and on to do much more horrible things.